Hello and welcome to Sweet Tea Hospitality Special Holiday Edition. I'm Karen Conrad and I'm so glad that you joined me today. I'm in my own kitchen in South Lake, Texas. And as you can see, we've had a lot of fun putting together charcuterie boards. Do you know, in our family, we love to do projects together really all year long. You've seen that from the renovations. And at holiday time, we especially like to get creative with food and with our home. And this is a really amazing spread of food, first of all, but it's a really fun project to work on. There's a lot of creativity involved, and charcuterie boards are just really fun, and they're really trending right now. It used to be where you'd maybe do one charcuterie board, but we have multiple right here, and I'm gonna share with you the 8 steps to putting together an amazing charcuterie board. And I want to invite you to do this with your family this holiday season. Do you know you can do all different types of boards? You can do something like we've done, more of a traditional meat and cheese. You can do a dessert charcuterie board. You can even do a candy one. Get your grandchildren involved and see what they come up with. You can use any theme that you would like. And we've been working on this for a couple days, and let me show you step by step how to put together a theme for your board and also how to pull all the decor together so when it's time for the family to gather around and enjoy a nice glass of wine and some snacks, everybody's going to feel special. We're all about hospitality. Do you know, hospitality is biblical, and what better time to show hospitality to friends and family than during the Christmas and New Year season? Okay, here are the 8 steps for you to put together your charcuterie board. Number 1, choose a theme. What theme do you want for your boards? You know, you could even do a Super Bowl party charcuterie board buffet. We chose to do a more traditional one with meat and cheese and brought in different types of fruits. We even have a little bit of desserts. We had so much fun picking out the theme. And number 2, the color. I like to have everything coordinated in the house. I don't want to just throw things together. I like to have a presentation that kind of ties into everything else that we're doing. So in this case, I chose a red theme. And as you can see, I've got some red roses that are super cheery. And then just adding some sparkly candle holders to bring that elegance in. I even brought in some red in the candy. I did strawberries with chocolate, which I'll share more about with you. But we chose a color, and every piece that we brought in was around that red theme. All right, number 3, you want to make a shopping list. We really need to do this because you know what happens? If we go to the store without a list, we end up with about 2 times more than what we really needed. But also we get kind of scattered when we get there and we lose our focus if we don't have a list. So what we did is we put together a list in line with our theme, and then we went to a couple different stores, and in the grocery store, we did a divide and conquer. And by that I mean that Dave went to one side of the store to pick out some items, I went to the other, and then we met in the middle. And it was just so much fun to see what each had picked out. The other thing is, when you go to a grocery store, we go to Central Market right here in South Lake, Texas. The people there are super passionate about what they do. And so we went to the section where they had the different kinds of meats, and Dave had a great time talking to them, and they told him about all the dried beef and the aged meat that is perfect for the charcuterie board. We also did a little research on charcuterie, and do you know that these boards have been around since the 15th century? They've just been trending now, and we're doing a little bit of a twist on it to bring it into 2021 and 2022. All right, so after you have your shopping list, number four is once you choose your space, like we did here with the island in our kitchen, you want to lay out the big pieces. And by that, I mean the different boards. So we have four boards here. So I started with the biggest board in the middle, and then I filled in the other boards to create interest and have some height. One of the most fascinating design tips that I learned as I got a little older is that not everything needs to be flat on the table. A matter of fact, when you use different heights, it brings a beauty and an elegance in, and that's exactly what we did with these boards. And as you can see, I've got roses, so I did different heights with roses as well. And so when you lay out a buffet like this, you want to have some movement with the heights. A little up and down, and then also have the flow make sense. So we start out with the plate on the end, and then as people go through and pick out what they want to eat and put on their plate, it goes through in a progression and ends up with the dessert. And in the meantime, they can enjoy the candlelight. One of the favorite things we do, which is part of our theme, is bacon. We love bacon in this household. So what are the favorite foods that you and your family enjoy? Incorporate those into your charcuterie boards. So we chose a theme, we chose a color, we made a shopping list, we did our layout of the major pieces, and then the next step is to fill in the little bowls after you've got the boards laid out. Now, these bowls that you see are very special to us. When we travel, we like to pick out bowls to add to our charcuterie collection. And so we've got one here that is from Amelia Island when we went on a trip, and it was somebody that made these. It's handmade. And then when Dave went over to the Middle East, he was in Jordan, he picked out these handmade little bowls, and they are so special. And so he was FaceTiming me from over there and had me pick out the ones I like. But you know, then when you're looking at this, it's not just food and boards, it's actually memories that you can create as a family. And that just adds to the experience of the holiday season and really any meal or any buffet or charcuterie that we put together. Okay, the next thing we want to do is start to layer in the food. And so when we got the meats and the prosciutto, we rolled those up and placed those. We have some grapes, and you want to do your food in clusters. There's just something about that, that first of all, people can see what it is, but when you put it in clusters, it gives a very interesting 3D dynamic to the charcuterie boards. Also, we have some silverware from Dave's grandma, and we added those in, some really, really amazing pieces. And those just can be talking points. It's things that you can share with your family and say, oh, this was grandma's, you know, this came from Jordan. Kind of create a nice conversation piece. We did some desserts on this towards the end, and I want to tell you, you do not have to be perfect. And that's part of the fun as well. Now, when I go to restaurants or nice places, they do these chocolate dipped strawberries, and they're absolutely delicious. So we decided that we were going to do that as part of our dessert. Now, ours didn't quite turn out as nice as what we've seen in restaurants. But again, you don't have to be perfect. They're a little bit lumpy, but they taste good. And I'll tell you, we talk about it frequently. Gosh, do you remember dipping the strawberry and it came up with chunks? But it just all adds to the experience. So you lay the food out, and then next, you want to fill it in with some special decor pieces. So what we chose to do, and again, we do this as a craft, we're always busy doing something. I got these tags, they're wooden tags at Michael's. They were on sale like 50% off. And then I got a red calligraphy marker. And so what we did is we just calligraphied on some nice messages and then placed them around on the trays, just kind of create some interest and a little bit of a surprise when people come over to the charcuterie buffet. Then we went in the backyard and we just picked out some rosemary. You might have some other things in your backyard or your garden to add. We will pull in some peppers, just interesting things to add. And you know what? You can get your kids involved with that too and your grandchildren. Have them pick out something in the house that they want to add to the buffet. And finally, you add the plates, the napkins, we've got our wine glasses, and one of our favorite bottles of wine, which is Austin Hope. And I want to point out, these are the cutest little plates. Dave and I went shopping, and we went to Kirkland's, which I go to a lot for furnishing the different properties we work on. And they have these little Christmas ball plates and they were 50% off and I just couldn't resist them. So they really added something, I think, to the buffet and the table. And I just smile when I look at these. Also, we went and picked out some napkins that went with the red and green and added those onto the buffet. And so when you take those 8 steps, you can use any type of theme that will work. And again, bring the family in. And I assure you that friends and family will feel your love and the hospitality of your home when you put your heart into building charcuterie boards. Thank you so much for joining me today for this special edition Sweet Tea Hospitality. Do you know I had my team write a blog on building charcuterie boards with all the 8 steps. So if you'd like to check that out, go to KarenConrad.net. You can go to my free downloads and get that completely free of charge. So from our family to yours, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.